Hey guys, what's up? I am the Storm Child. So it's Wednesday. That means, of course, another Nightwish reaction is coming. But yeah, I haven't said this sentence in a long time because that was the beginning of my channel when I have done a Nightwish song every Wednesday. But I think I have done so many. You can find them all on my channel if you are interested. A lot of Nightwish stuff here on my channel if you are watching the first time. And if you're interested, of course. So yeah, but today I'm gonna check out the Islander again, I have to say, because I have done a reaction video for the official video, because I think that is one of the most beautiful Nightwish videos ever, if not the beautiful one. If that's a correct English sentence, I have no idea, but it doesn't matter. So yeah, this is a bit, now while I'm doing this live, Tampere, it was released officially by Nightwish on YouTube, I think 1 or 2 weeks ago. You already know that, I think. And I thought, okay, with a bit of Marco nostalgia already, yeah, I thought it would be a great idea to watch this again. I was never the biggest fan of the Tampere concert, to be honest. Just because of the sound, that's the only reason, honestly. But yeah, maybe I have to come back to this one. I own the Blu-ray, of course, of this amazing concert and Wembley show. I think everybody has this Blu-ray set of these two awesome concerts. But I think the sound was a bit of the problem, but maybe I was totally wrong because I haven't watched this in a while. And so yeah, we learned that they have a new bass player already, and they will show him to the world at the virtual concert in the end of May, because it was postponed. And yeah, I have a bit mixed feeling with this VIP access with presenting him to the world, but I think everybody has his own opinion. And yeah, I'm curious who is gonna be. Tell me that in the comments if you have an idea. I have no idea, honestly. I just will wait and then I will be surprised. Maybe I will do a video for that, of course. So yeah, but we talk about the Islander. Great, great song. Also, I think, if my informations are correct, the music was written by Marco Hietala and the lyrics are from Tuomas Holopainen. So it fits so perfect that Marco is singing this song, and I can remember it was a great live performance, and I can wait to listen to it again in great quality. So with that said, oh, I'm in the Nightwish mood today. Oh, damn. That's why I'm wearing my one shirt. It's now 17 years old. Time flies, time flies. And with that said, no, I have to do this, not this. I just wanted to do the camera out. So yeah, with that said, let's do it. An old man by a seashore at the end of day gazes the horizon with sea wind in his face. Tempest tossed silent, seasons all the same. Anchor urgent painted and a ship without a name. Sea without a shore for the vanished one on her. Light as the beacon light at the end of world, showing their way, lighting hope in their hearts. Once in their travels home, what from afar.
Eli jos mä soitaisin kertosäkeen, niin te varmaan laulatte mukana. Laulatte? Okei, sit se vedetään.
This is for long forgotten, light at the end of the world, horizon crying, the tears he left behind long ago. The albatross is flying, making him daydream. Time before he became one of the world's unseen. Princess in the tower, children in the fields, Life gave him it all, and now I know the universe. Ah, now his love's a memory, ghost in the fog, sets the sails for last and saying farewell to the world. Anchored to the ward, I see it far below, wrestling his feet and a smile beneath his brow. This is for long forgotten light at the end of the world. Horizon crying, the tears he left behind long ago.
So yeah, that was really cool to watch this again. Yeah, and it was really beautiful, honestly. It was really cool. But I have to complain a bit about the beginning of the video, because it just started from the first second, and when it comes to me, it would be cool if they just left 10 seconds or something with a crowd cheering or something. Maybe you have the same feeling, because it was just like, oh, okay, it started. But of course, we can all watch the concert on Blu-ray or DVD. But I was just surprised, and that is the only thing I can complain, honestly. Because it was really beautiful. Also, I have to say, and I just had this feeling again when I think about it, that this is, I think, one of the best songs sung by Marco Hietala, because it is a more calmer one, and I think that fits perfect, because in the most other tracks he has this beast part with the beauty and the beast part, and he's just like really heavy and strong and everything, and this one is a bit calmer, and I really like that. Also in calmer tarot songs, it's just like that is where Marco can really shine in a different way, I have to say. But this is really beautiful, and I like this song from the first listening of the Dark Passion Play album. It's not my favorite album. You can also watch that in the album reviews together with Phil. They are really entertaining. We talked about that. But that was one of my favorites. Not also because of the video, but also, it has this great feeling. And also, I think it was the first time Troy appeared in a Nightwish music video. He looks way different back then, because it is really entertaining. But I think also that he is now a part of Nightwish is definitely good, especially when it comes to a song like this in the live performance. I think since the recordings there, Troy was nearly every time there live and on tour. Because with a Dark Passion Play tour, I think I've saw Troy on every concert. So this is great. And for such a song, it fits absolutely perfect. So to the performance, I think it's really cool. Of course, in the great stadium of Tampere, it's really great when you have this great crowd. And I think also the lineup for this show was amazing. I think support like were Children of Bodom and Sonata Arctica, also bands I really like. So I would love to be at this concert. And I think also it's really cool that Marco is beginning alone in the middle of the crowd. How you can say it, it's just a beautiful moment. I think also for him it was a really special moment, and for the whole crowd also, when he wants that the crowd sing along. I have no idea what he had said in Finnish. Maybe he can tell me that in the comments, would be interesting, but I think it was something like, can we sing the next part, the chorus together or something? Maybe. Tell me if I'm wrong. But it's something like that, I think. And also, I think what was really priceless was when Kai kicked in with the drum and the whole instrumentation kicked in with the whole band. It was just like when you see the smile on Marco's face, he's just like, yeah, like he's really enjoying the show as well. It's just like, I think it's a great feeling and a cool way to perform, because on this tour it was the Endless Forms Most Beautiful tour, yeah, and they changed the set list from concert to concert with three or four songs, and it was just like, I think it was between The Islander or Idimaru or Wishmaster or something like that, and they changed that every time. And I was on this tour a few times, but I never saw this Islander perform live, which was sad, because with this newer version, you can call it, but yeah, I never seen this performance live, so it's even better to watch this live again. I also have to say that I prefer the version with Annette. I have to say it, honestly, I have to say it, because you all know I like Floor 2 and I had nothing to do with it, but I think that is one of the coolest Annette moments in Nightwish history is when she kicked in into Islander on the Dark Passion Play. It's so great and heartwarming, and that is for me forever the best version, because that is also a moment where Annette really shined with her voice and it fits so perfect. So nothing against the version with Floor, but I think this Annette version is better. But yeah, maybe I have a different opinion, but I think that is so cool. So, but it has nothing to do with the live performance. This is great in this great stadium, and it was absolutely fantastic to see this live again. And yeah, I think we all miss Marco already, but I mean, in Nightwish history nowadays, I mean, there were so many new members coming, and there was never an ending or something. It was just a bit different, also with the singer, of course, and so I'm not sure what to expect, but I'm sure I'm gonna like it too, because there was no member change that I thought, okay, I can't listen to Nightwish anymore or something. Okay, that would be really stupid. But it's a big part and I can wait. And I'm wondering if the new bass player is also going to sing or how they manage it. It will be interesting, definitely. So again, tell me your ideas about the new bass player or singer. It's going to be different, but maybe this will be another step. So it's really curious to listen to the whole discography of Nightwish and rewind, because yeah, there were many changes. Let's see. So tell me your thoughts about this live performance and your thoughts about Marco. We talked about that in another video, I know that, but thank you there for the comments, of course. Really great. I read them all, you can be sure. So hopefully you have a great day, guys. This will be, I think, the only video till next Tuesday, because my beautiful girlfriend Christina has birthday tomorrow, and I will be at her apartment till Tuesday. And so yeah, that's more important. Love is always more important than YouTube videos, you know that. So with that said, if you like this video, of course, please subscribe my channel, it would be so awesome. And if you want to support me and my new music project in the future, you can find the link in the description, it would be very helpful. And hopefully we see us the next time. I'm the Stone Child. Bye.